Namaste. Welcome to Yoga for Unity and Wellbeing, 100 days towards the International Day of Yoga. We are joined by Aarti Pal. This young lady is exceptional in the fact that she is an assistant professor at the University of Patanjali in Haridwar, north of India. She is a multiple-time Yogasana sports champion, a gold medalist, and having started at a very young age, she made yoga her study, her life. Right now, she's pursuing a PhD in yoga. How does it change the psychology of young girls between the ages of 7 to 15? Aarti is graceful when she's on the mat. She has multiple disciplines of yoga under her belt. Artistic yoga, rhythmic yoga, and several other manners in which she expresses herself. It is a beauty to behold. She's going to talk to us about yoga as something that can help us for personality development. How does this change our life? How does practicing yoga, which looks like nothing much to start with, especially because the approach is so soft, even for people who take it just as an exercise, yoga can do miracles. Aarti is going to take us on a journey to see how yoga can be a holistic and a complete way to develop ourselves. Join Aarti and let's listen to her. Such exceptional wisdom at such a young age. Namaste.
Namaste. My greetings to all. Today I'm going to share my thoughts on role of yoga in personality development. Yoga is generally looked upon as a system of therapy, and many look upon yoga as a system of fitness as well. And definitely there is a group which believes that yoga is just a philosophy. But very few of us are aware that yoga can be a great medium for overall personality development of the students if we talk about yoga at education level. Because whenever we talk about education, it's not just about giving the students the knowledge to recognize the letters, to recognize the alphabets, and even the education is not about making your students efficient to learn the history, to mug up the science, to mug up the technology. Definitely they are the part of education, but they built only intellectual aspect of the personality. So intellectual aspect of the personality can't be considered as overall personality development. At the same time, when I'm talking about intellectual aspect, I would like to tell about the physical aspect as well. Because many are confused that if we have good physical appearance, we have a good personality. Nowadays, there are a number of coaching classes are running in the market. They are making huge, huge money in the name of personality development classes. A big market is going on in the name of PD classes. And what is being taught there? There they are working on just physical traits. A big task is being taken on to groom the physical traits. But only physical aspect again is not going to give you overall personality development. And so first of all, it is very much important to understand what is actually overall personality development. When we talk about overall personality development, what should we mean or what should we understand by this term? So the educationist says that overall personality development is the growth and development at physical level, at mental level, emotional level, intellectual level, social level, and spiritual level. So when we consider all these aspects, then only we can talk about overall personality development. So now let's understand these aspects individually, that what these aspects are and how the system of yoga can contribute to these all aspects of personality development. I, as a student of yoga class, used to listen one chapai of Ramayan from my Guruji. He always used to say that he used to state that chapai, and that chapai of Ramacharitmanas, it was like this: Guru Graha Padhan Gaye Raghurai, Guru Graha Padhan Gaye Raghurai, Alpakal Vidya Sab Pai, Vidya Vinaya Sakal Gun Shila, Khela Hi Khela Karai Nripalila. All these four lines are very much important. Guru Graha Padhan Gaye Raghurai. Now Raghurai is denoting Lord Rama. Lord Rama has gone to, or had gone to, Gurukul for his education. Alpakal Vidya Sab Pai. In a very short span of time, he learned all the things. He acquired education. What education did he acquire? Vidya, Vinaya, Sakal Guna Shila. Vidya. He acquired knowledge. He became intellectually strong. Vinaya, he developed humbleness, he developed moral values, he developed social values. Sakala Gunashila, it means apart from these aspects, apart from these values also, he earned or he learned some other values also. And then Khelahi Khela Karai Nripalila, and finally he acquired that knowledge also, or I should say that he acquired the professional knowledge also. So our education system or the education always tells about this fact, that the student's development or the personality development should take place in all the aspects. And we are so fortunate that in the form of yoga, we have such a system which, if combined with education, can be a great medium for overall personality development. So now let's understand about all the different aspects of personality, and how with the system of yoga, how with the practice of yoga, we are going to develop all those aspects. And so it is very much important to understand all different aspects, all those individual aspects. Because when we understand those individual aspects individually, then only we will be able to understand these aspects completely about overall personality development. So let's start first with the physical aspects of personality. The physical aspect of personality, a very important aspect of personality. Because nowadays, in the name of personality development, the thing that we are considering is the physical aspect only. But the physical aspect also, we are unknown completely to. We are not fully aware with what all components are there in your physical aspects of personality. We just think that if our body posture is good, we have dressed up nicely, our personality is good. That can be just a part of your personality. Having a good posture, having a good talk, having a good language may be just a part of your physical traits. But when we talk about physical aspects of personality as a whole, we have to consider some other things also in that. What all those other things are? In your physical aspect of personality, other than the physical traits, your physical fitness components are also there, which should be considered. We hardly think of the fitness components, or we are not aware with those fitness components. What are those fitness components, physical fitness components? Our physical fitness component are lying in our cardiovascular health. How healthy our lung, our heart, our blood vessels are, that is also a component of your physical fitness. After your cardiovascular health, your muscular strength and your muscular endurance is also going to be considered when it comes to your physical fitness. Also, your flexibility is considered when your fitness is considered. So, for having good physical aspect or for the development of your physical aspect, along with the physical traits, you have to work upon your physical health as well, and you have to work upon your fitness components as well. There should not be any disease in your body, because if you are having outer good look but you are suffering with the diseases, you won't be considered physically healthy. So along with touching up your outer body, along with making over your outer body, you have to work on your health also. You have to work on your fitness components also. You have to work on your cardiovascular health. You have to work on your muscular strength and endurance. You have to work on your flexibility. And also you should have a healthy body composition. That is also a very important component of your physical health, and that is also an important aspect of your physical trait of personality. So this is how your physical health is going to make up your personality. And again, I would like to add that by the practice of yogasanas and pranayama, you can very well address all these challenges. By the practice of asanas and pranayama, you can have good cardiovascular health, you can develop your flexibility, you can have good muscular endurance, strength, and also the practice of asanas and pranayama work as a prevention for your health. I mean, it saves your body, it protects your body, it prevents your body from several diseases, as it increases your immunity, it boosts your immunity power also. So this is how by the practice of yoga or yoga abhyas can help you to develop your physical aspect. Then after physical aspect, the second important aspect of your personality is your mental aspect. Mental and emotional. Mental and emotional aspect is again a very important aspect of personality. As I told you, that when we are talking about personality development, being good at one part does not make surety that you are overall good or you are overall healthy or you are overall developed. If you have very good physique, if you have very good strength, you have good flexibility, but your pattern of thinking is not good. In a very small situation, or if you face very little problem, you become stressed or you get into depression, then you are not mentally healthy. And if you are not mentally healthy, your personality development has not taken place as a whole. Nowadays, I see that at the school level, at the student level, the children are getting, or children are taking a lot of stress. They are going into depression. They are committing suicide. They are even, sometimes I have gone through the news where students have attempted to shoot their friend with a gun. I mean, it was just crossing the limit. This is why, because the mental aspect has not developed as a whole. We generally confuse between the intellectual and mental. Your intellectual aspect is actually different and your mental and emotional aspect is little different. So if the person is going into stress, depression, his thinking pattern is not good, his thinking pattern is negative, it means he or she is not mentally strong. So the mental aspect is also very much important. And so it is very much important to consider the mental aspect also. Because if physique is good, physical personality is good, physically your body is healthy, but as I told you, that if you are mentally not strong, then again your personality is not developed as a whole. As I was giving the example that at the school level, students are coming up with a lot of depression, with a lot of stress. Not only about the student, but nowadays, this stress, this depression is lying in the society at each and every stage and at each and every level. Even a housewife is taking a lot of stress. Even a person who is into job, who is serving into his or her office, he or she is also taking a lot of stress. And so if stress is there, if anxiety is there, if depression is there, the personality is not developed as a whole. Along with this mental part, we also need to think, we also need to consider our emotions. We all are being driven by either negative emotions or by our positive emotions. If we are generally driven by our negative emotions, then also we are not healthy. If we always have jealousy, we always have malice, we are always sad by the progress of others, then also we are not healthy. And that's why it is said that nowadays, number of people are not healthy. Because though they are working a lot on their physical level, though they are working a lot on their body, but they are not working on their emotion. On very small things, we get angry. Anger has become such an emotion which has gone out of our control. A small child also, he's getting a lot of anger. In the house, in the society, all the major things are taking place, all the major tragedies are taking place because of this anger. So we need to work on our emotions. And when this emotional part is also taken care of, when we are driven by the positive emotions, then we can say that emotional development and mental development is also taking place. And then we will be able to say that the overall personality development will take place as a whole. By the practice of yoga abhyas, again I will say that we are so fortunate that we are blessed with the treasure of Ashtanga Yoga. We generally think that asana and pranayama are the practical aspect of Ashtanga Yoga. But Swamiji says that all these Ashtangic Yoga part or all these eight limbs are completely practical. If we start implementing, if we start teaching, if we start imbibing yamas and niyamas from the very initial level, from the very primary level, from the student's level or from the childhood level only, then you will see that a lot of mental and emotional problems can be solved. Because nowadays the very important thing that we are losing is the contentment, santosh. We are losing that santosh. Because that is a term, the contentment, that is a term which hardly people know about. And again, I would like to quote here the Chaupai of Ramayana, which says that Godhana Gajadhana Bajidhana. Godhana, गज धन बाज धन और रतन धन खान, जब आवे संतोष धन सब धन धूरि समान। वेदर यू हैव गोधन, दैट इज द काउ दैट वॉज ऑल्सो कंसिडर्ड एज अ काइंड ऑफ एसेट, गज धन द एलिफेंट, बाज धन द हॉर्स, ऑल दीज वर कंसिडर्ड एज द assets in older times, in ancient times. So all these kind of assets, aur ratan dhan khan, and all kind of wealth if you get, jab aave santosh dhan, when you actually get contentment, or when you learn the quality, or when you develop the quality of contentment, सब धन धूरी समान, ऑल दीज वेल्थ आर गोइंग टू बी लाइक ऑफ नो यूज. सो कंटेंटमेंट इज द की, एंड बाय द प्रैक्टिस ऑफ यमाज नियमाज प्रैक्टिस, व्हेन आई एम यूजिंग प्रैक्टिस आई एम आस्किंग टू इम्बाइबिंग दोज वैल्यूज, आई एम आस्किंग टू इम्बाइबिंग दोज यमाज एंड नियमाज इन द लाइफ. सो व्हेन दोज वैल्यूज आर इम्बाइब्ड at the level of students, at the level of adults, at the level of senior citizens, then automatically the problem of mental development and emotional development is going to be addressed. Now there is the next aspect, that is intellectual aspect, which we had started with. So intellectual aspect is also very much important, and that refers to the intellectual capacity of the person. And it has been found that yoga abhyas has been found very much important in increasing the intellectual capacity of the students, of the person. There are a number of researches have been carried which shows that the practice of yogic techniques have shown good improvement in the memory, in the concentration level of the students. And why about the students? Even I would like to give my example. I also started yoga abhyas as a student in my 8th standard. In my 8th standard, I was an average child, but with the improvements by the practice of yoga abhyas, somehow I was able to score 78%. My yoga abhyas, my yogasana practice was continued then. And in my 10th standard, in my board standard, I then scored 86%. So from 78, it reached to 86. And then again in my 12th standard, I scored 89%. So this is something which is there on the paper. But individually also, I felt a lot of improvement in my memory and concentration power. My memory became so strong that I learned all the shlokas of Bhagavad Gita. Even I attempted to learn Ramayana. I am still into the progress, I am still into the practice. So here, by giving my example, I am just trying to say that by yoga abhyas, the intellectual part can also be very much stronger. And when we talk about personality as a whole, then as I told you that we can't underestimate any of the aspect. So intellectual aspect is also very much important. So intellectual aspect is very well addressed or very well dealt by the practice of yoga abhyas. Yoga abhyas also gives the confidence to the person. Because when we acquire education, when we become intellectual, it is supposed that we must have the confidence to share our knowledge. We must have confidence to speak up what all we have learned. How should be our language? So that all part is also, that confidence part is also very well addressed by the practice of yoga abhyas. There also the researches have been done where it has been found that by the practice of pranayama, breathing lengthens and it gives you it. There is a complete mechanism. I am not going to get into the mechanism, But by the practice, it gave the confidence as well. So intellectually also, this yoga abhyas is going to make you strong. And then after intellectual aspect, then comes the next aspect, is the social aspect. We have always heard that human is the social person, or the man is a social person. So just being into the sentences that we are social person or human is a social person does not give the guarantee or does not make the surety that we are socially also very much developed. Because when we talk about the social aspect, we expect that the student, that the person, he must know that how he or she should conduct in the society. If the conduction of the person in the society is not proper, if the person, even after being physically fit, even after being mentally fit, or even being intellectually very much strong, is not following the rules of the society, is not behaving properly in the society, then also we will say that the personality is not developed as a whole. If we are unable to follow the social rules, we won't say that the social development has taken place properly. Whatever rules of the society are there, they are very well explained as the part of yamas. If you go for the yamas, you will find that yamas talk about ahimsa, asteya, and all those values which are very much necessary to keep a good society or to behave properly in the society. If you are very good at yourself or at physical level, you are very good. But when you go into the society, you are always quarreling with others. You are pelting stone on the dog. You are not taking care of the others who are there in the society. Whatever you are willing to do, you are just doing it without taking care of others, without thinking of others, that by your action, if someone is getting hurt, or if by your other some kind of enjoyment, if others are getting some kind of disturbances, if you are not able to think of others, if you are not able to think of the society, then also it can't be said that the social development has taken place. If a person is very much healthy at physical level, doing all good at intellectual level, but he or she does not know how to conduct in the society, if he or she, whenever he or she is there in the society, always quarreling with others, always pelting stone on the dog, unable to adjust into the society, unable to enjoy the programs of the society. Here, by program, I mean to say that unable to enjoy the enjoyness of the others. Then also, we can't say that the person is socially developed. And when we talk about the overall personality development, we have to consider each and every aspect as a whole. And you will see that in our Ashtangic Yoga path, very well social values have been described in the form of Yama. If the Yama is implemented, if Yama is followed, then automatically the social values are going to develop in the students as well as amongst the citizens. And so the social development will take place. The person will learn to live in the society. The person will learn to follow the social values of the society. And so by the practice of yoga abhyas, the social development can also take place. And now after social aspect, last but not the least, is the very important aspect, is the spiritual aspect. The spiritual aspect, which is the most important aspect of the personality. Because the yogic perspective says that our aim is not just to take birth here, just to earn money and to die. That is not only the aim of this human birth. We need to drive our life through spirituality. We need to have spiritual values, that is the higher values, higher positive values in our life. Our each and every action should be driven by spirituality. The practice of asanas, the practice of pranayam, the practice of meditation helps to develop the spiritual values in the life. It changes our attitude. It makes our attitude positive towards the life. Because many a times when everything is there in the life, but if you lack in the spiritual value, you might find all those things are not able to give you the satisfaction. They are not able to give you the contentment. They are not actually able to give you the happiness. Because we have always heard that happiness is not just lying in outer objects or the physical materials. They give us happiness, but that happiness is temporary. The permanent happiness is going to be felt only when we are spiritual. Because that permanent happiness is lying inside. And to feel that happiness, we have to develop the spiritual values. When you sit in the meditation for half an hour, you don't feel actually awkward. Rather, you feel happiness. You don't feel crying. Rather, you feel enjoyment. Because the meditation, these yogic techniques are actually helpful to develop the spiritual values, or rather they are helpful to develop a positive attitude towards the life. And so all these aspects are very much important for overall personality development. So this is how the spiritual aspect is also very much important. Because we are going to be driven by all these aspects. We have to be physically healthy. We have to be mentally strong. We have to be emotionally healthy, emotionally strong. We have to be intellectually sharp, intellectually strong. We have to develop the social values. And as I told you, last but not very least, we have to develop spirituality in the life. Because if spirituality is there, we are going to enjoy this life. All what we are doing today, all whatever we will be doing tomorrow, whatever profession we are into, whatever work we are into, if we develop spirituality, we are going to enjoy our field, we are going to enjoy our work. And then what Lord Krishna has said in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Yoga karmashu kaushalam. So automatically when you develop all these values, you developed all these qualities, you are going to get perfect in your work. You are going to perform your work efficiently. And your wish for the result is also going to be changed. Because your attitude toward the work is going to be changed. We are going to perform our work efficiently. And then automatically, yoga is going to take place from all of us in each of our work. And when yoga is taking place in each of our work, in each of our thought, in our knowledge, we are going to have a happy society. And as I started with the overall personality development, so we have seen that by the practice of yoga abhyas, we are going to develop all these facets, all these aspects of personality. And so we have to be a regular practitioner of yoga. Yoga definitely is a philosophy, but I would like to add that yoga is not just a matter of words. It has to be implemented. It has to be practiced. It has to be experienced. And then it has to be shared. And if we, when we implement yoga in our life, we imbibe all the yogic values in our life, we practice regularly yoga abhyas, we are definitely going to have overall personality development. Thank you very much for giving me a patient listening. I would like to end up my talk here. Thank you very much. Namaste.